Greetings to all the promising and sincere learners. I am Pallavi Tandon, Faculty of English at SRN International School, situated in Jagatpura, Jaipur. Today, we will be continuing with the poem 6 titled Aunt Jennifer's Tiger from NCERT book Flamingo of Grade 12. This podcast will help you to understand the theme of the poem, justification of the title, and various images and symbols used by the poet in a very simplified manner. Now, let me start with the theme of the poem. The poem is clearly a feminist poem and revolves around the theme of male chauvinism and gender conflicts. The theme of the victimization of the women by their male counterparts has been starkly brought out in the poem, making it a forceful expression of the evils of patriarchy. Aunt Jennifer is totally victimized and suffers the oppression of her male counterpart even though he is absent. She is never able to liberate herself from the oppression of custom and law. Aunt Jennifer thus creates for herself an alternate world of freedom, one which she can inhabit only in her imagination. Next we have the title. Aunt Jennifer's Tiger is an appropriate title in that it refers to a tapestry Aunt Jennifer has made. It contains some ferocious, proud, fearless, and prancing tigers. The title also suggests the tiger, like terror, Aunt's husband was. She was in constant fear of him and felt trapped and suffocated in marriage. She felt that her husband was her master and she was a tame animal who must carry out his command. It is truly a very suggestive title indeed. Now, let's move to images and symbols. Poetry banks heavily on literary devices to make a mark on the reader's mind. A poem that doesn't touch the heart loses its appeal, which is enhanced with imagery and symbols. Symbolism is the art of using an object or a word to represent an abstract idea. In this piece of poetry, Andriana Rich has used various symbols to give a deep insight to the reader's mind. Tiger. Tiger has been used as a symbol of terror and oppression perpetrated on women like Aunt Jennifer by the male world. It also symbolizes the freedom of spirit which Aunt Jennifer dreams of, but is never able to achieve. Next, bright topaz. Bright yellowish brown color of the tiger skin is symbolized with the help of this word, bright topaz. Next, the poet has used the image of fluttering wool. It highlights the extensive oppression of the women. Aunt Jennifer is so victimized and oppressed that her frail fingers are not able to carry the weight or something even as light as wool. Her struggling with the ivory needles suggests the loss of her individual identity under the weight of uncle's domination and her terrorized state of mind. Next, uncle's wedding band. It symbolizes the suppression of women in matrimony. The wedding band is symbolic of the oppression of women by custom and law. It also symbolizes so-called male authority and dominance. For many men, women are possessions. Next, ringed with ordeals. It is an image used by poet to express the struggles of the spirit, racial and religious injustice and oppression that Aunt Jennifer suffers, but never expresses or complains against. No one knows the trauma Aunt Jennifer has had to undergo. Repetition of Aunt Jennifer and tigers create a horrifying ambience of the oppressor and the oppressed. The theme of male chauvinism runs throughout the poem, creating a fearsome atmosphere of tigers on the prowl of a prey. I hope, students, you must have understood well the theme, the title of the poetry, and various images and symbols used by the poet. Listen to the podcast attentively and appreciate the poetry. Thank you.